graduating class of 2020, parents, family, and friends. Welcome to the Paducah Tilghman High School virtual graduation. I hope you all are safe and well and are able to be with your family as you watch this ceremony. Although we could look at this as a sad occasion, since we are not together at a traditional ceremony, I choose to be happy, and I invite everyone to take part in celebrating our seniors' accomplishments. When we look back upon this class in years to come, I bet we will think of two words, resilience and grit. Resilience is defined as the capacity to recover quickly from difficulties or toughness, while grit is having courage and resolve, or one's strength of character. What our seniors have been through, especially at the end of this year, I know will only make them stronger. Seniors, you have gotten a taste of what the real world can be like. Sometimes you just have to make lemonade out of lemons. And I know you've made a lot of lemonade lately. So on behalf of the faculty and staff at Paducah Tilghman High School, we present to you the Class of 2020 virtual graduation.
Ladies and gentlemen, today I would like to introduce Paducah Tilghman High School Band of Blue, conducted by James Gregory. The band will be performing Songs of Old Kentucky, I, John Riley, with Wayfaring Stranger by Brant Carrick.
The Class of 2020 Paducah Tilghman High School Salutatorian is Mr. Ryan Chua. Ryan is the son of Mr. Winston and Rona B. Chua. His post-secondary plans include attending the University of Michigan, where he plans to major in computer science. Congratulations, Ryan.
Before I begin, I'd like to say that although I would have loved to deliver this speech in person, I am grateful to be able to say that I am safe and my loved ones are as well. I hope that everyone watching this is likewise safe and healthy, and that everyone is receiving the emotional, financial, or medical support needed to get through these trying times. You've heard the expression, life is like a box of chocolates. Well, I'm kind of severely allergic to most chocolates, so allow me to substitute a more palatable expression. Life is like a fistful of Sour Patch Kids. 2020 has been a haphazard year, with one unpredictable disaster after another. First, our country almost became a participant in a Third World War, something we narrowly avoided. An entire continent almost burned to the ground, only for the flames to be extinguished on the brink of eradication. Now, times are bleak again. World activities have come to a grinding halt. Unemployment rates have skyrocketed. And worst of all, our loved ones are at risk of falling ill. However, all hope isn't lost. Like I said, fistful of Sour Patch Kids. Right now, things are sour, but eventually, they will turn sweet. We didn't end up actually going to war with each other. Instead, the world has waged a war together as one against this virus. The bushfires are extinguished, and signs of new life are already apparent. On top of all of that, we are here, graduating amidst a global pandemic. This school, like countless others across the nation, took every measure possible to ensure a graduation for us, and they did it. We are lucky to live in a time where we can all be connected, even if we're not together. In this time of constant shock, sweet is simply the absence of sour. But let's be honest, we'll take any sweet we can get. First, I want to commend the efforts of the school. Thank you, Principal Steve, for creating new ways to incentivize learning. I don't think you expected your first year as principal to end like this. Thank you to the administrators and guidance counselors for quickly adapting and patiently answering everyone's questions. Let's give a huge thank you to the teachers who have been continuously working their butts off. They've physically delivered work to students and still held class, along with supplemental sessions when we needed it. For us AP students, they are still preparing us to take our exams, even if the school year is already over. Let's also give a large thank you to the kitchen and custodial staff, both of whom are ensuring that Tilghman is and will once again be a secure environment for all students. Thank you to my extended family who have been with me through thick and thin. And finally, thank you to my wonderful parents, and Renee, I guess. I know that you've been through a lot to get yourselves to where you are today, to build the wonderful and happy family that I find myself a part of. I don't think you expected your journey from the Philippines to end up here. Excluding the fact that I was indeed born, I still cannot have done it without them. By the way, Mom, I know you're taking photos of me right now. This is a pre-recorded video and all, so you kind of don't need to do that, but I won't stop you. Mostly because I can't stop you. For those of you watching at home, which is everyone, I hope, I ask that you take some time to thank your parents as well. All of this is to say that despite all the sour in the world, there's plenty of sweet right here. Speaking of sweet, let's talk about our class. This class is truly something else, because somehow they convinced me to attend the football game. Now, if you know me at all, you know that I have zero affinity for sports. I did somehow find myself on the field for recognition in anything but sports. But in all seriousness, we have a phenomenal class. We have record breakers, entrepreneurs, talented musicians who have earned awards and performed in many competitions and shows. We have one of the best track teams in the whole state and some of the smartest people in Kentucky. Paducah Tilghman's very stacked, and we should be proud of that. Over the course of my high school career, I picked up a few things. For example, this piece of paper right here. But in all seriousness, I have also taken up some less tangible things, and I would like to share those with you. According to Malcolm Gladwell's Outliers, it takes approximately 10,000 hours to attain mastery at something. Since August 10, 2016, just under 33,000 hours have passed. While I haven't mastered anything yet, I would like to impart some advice I've learned along the way. The sharing of knowledge is just as important as receiving it, as without sharing, knowledge has no value. The first piece of advice I'd like to share is to always try new things and challenge yourself, even if you think it's a bad idea in the process. Always attempt to answer questions and solve problems. Find new ways to do the same tasks. Wear all white to blackout. Take that ridiculously difficult course load. Buy that $30 oversized pack of Uno that is literally impossible to shuffle, just so you can say you own it. Remember to spend responsibly, kids. Also, shout out to Mr. King for creating the swap of the discard pile custom card. The amount of entertainment you've provided me at the cost of my friend's sanity is priceless. All in all, just make life spicy. Make life something you want to reminisce on. The second lesson is simple. Just be nice to people. Trust sows the seeds of freedom, and a little respect truly does go a long way. It can even solve a few of the world's problems. You'll never know when you will need to fall back on someone, so build those strong connections early and maintain them. Lastly, the phrase, I don't know, is powerful. By admitting ignorance, you are asking to learn. I know that I will come upon a hard stop, and I hope that when I do, I'll pause and remind myself ask for a hand of enlightenment so that I might come out of that hard experience knowing more than when I started. This is a concept that will take me more than 10,000 hours to accept. Just last week, I felt this way as I stared at a blank document, panicked and terrified. I know that many of you are feeling this way right now and even before the pandemic. There isn't a formula on how to get all the answers, so why not make one? Try a solution and follow through, even if it's unconventional, given it's legal, of course. Out of ideas? This is where being nice comes in. Those who reciprocate your kindness are the ones you want to keep, and they'll want to keep you too. If you don't feel like you have anyone you can rely on, reach out, find them. Life rarely hands you a golden opportunity, so make one. Just as a tornado creates a wake in its path of destruction, so too will this class of 2020 create their own. Hopefully without the whole destruction part. You are going to do amazing things. You already have. I'll let honors night praise your accomplishments, so I'll end on this. Don't let your dreams be memes. If you don't start the day off on the right foot, start on the left. Throw a quarantine party and invite no one. Congratulations, graduates of 2020, on completing the first step in this little choose-your-own-adventure that we like to call adulthood. Stay sweet, guys. Thank you.
The class of 2020 Paducah Tilghman High School valedictorian is Kate Kreiner. Kate is the daughter of Mr. Andrew and Mrs. Janie Kreiner. Her post-secondary plans include attending the University of Louisville, where she plans to major in psychology and neuroscience. Congratulations, Kate.
Planning on starting the speech by greeting everyone, but considering that I'm speaking to a camera, thanking you all for coming seems a bit strange. I never could have imagined our high school careers ending like this, but in a way it makes sense. I never thought that we were a conventional class. When I think about all of you, I cannot even begin to generalize. We are not just an artsy class or an athletic class or an academic class. We are not just troublemakers or creatives or leaders. We are all of that and more. Being at Tilghman these past 4 years has taught me so much. I learned that you can never make too many friends, that you should never go up the downstairs, that eventually even the most squeamish of freshmen can get used to the roaches, and that an entire double block classroom of boys can break into Mr. Morris's hotel room and have a dance party in DC with minimal punishment. I learned how to find balance and trust in my teammates, whether it was during a speech competition, on a tennis court, or in a courtroom. But the most important thing that Tilghman has taught me is that it's always okay to ask for help. So when I sat down to write this, I knew I couldn't do it alone. I realized that no matter how hard I tried, my words could not define a class like mine. So I reached out to some of my classmates and teachers asking for 3 words to describe the Tilghman class of 2020. Our teachers had a lot to say about our class. We are compassionate and kind, hilarious and quirky, intelligent and outgoing. We are savvy. We have intensity and integrity, and apparently we are very entertaining. One of the words our teachers use most may be confused as merely a product of the world's current state. We are described as resilient, and yes, of course, navigating online school for the past few months and losing nearly every important aspect of our senior year while still choosing to keep our heads up earns us that distinction. But so does our willingness to communicate and collaborate with our teachers and faculty. This was Ms. Steek's first year as our principal. I know, quite possibly the hardest first year for any principal ever, but I am so grateful for the time we got to spend with her. At the very beginning of the year, there was a rumor going around that she was not going to allow the seniors to paint up for the Mayfield game. And while it was just that, a rumor, my class sprang into action. We launched a petition and wrote a formal letter. But before we could even send the letter, Ms. Steek called us into her office to set the record straight. Even though our fight was cut short, I saw what my class was capable of, receiving upsetting news and instead of choosing complacency, rising up and telling the world what we believe in. That is resilience. In our own words, we are strong-willed and determined. We are loud. Loud enough to win the class yell-off as juniors, loud enough to walk out and protest, loud enough to stand up for what we believe in. And while we are goofy, rambunctious, and headstrong, the word I found that best describes us is family. Anytime I'm asked about Tilghman, about the teachers or the clubs or the people, the word I say first is family. My favorite thing about our school is that there is no one way to be a Tilghman kid. We do not let ourselves be defined as merely an athlete or a scholar or a band nerd. With Tilghman, you don't have to choose. I want to thank all of you. Thank you to our parents and families for supporting us, to our amazing faculty for making Tilghman so incredible, and to our teachers for allowing us to grow our understanding of the world. Thanks to all of you, we are empowered and emboldened to rise to the occasion and do the things we love, no matter the circumstance of the world, no matter how crushed we may feel. Being here with all of you has taught me that the Tilghman Party absolutely does not stop. Thank you.
I would like to introduce our concert choir seniors, directed by Matthew J. Hines, performing The Lord Bless and Keep You by Peter Lutkin.
Student Award is presented annually to the graduating senior who, through academic achievement, extracurricular activities, service, character, and integrity, best exemplifies the values and traditions of Paducah-Tilghman High School. The six distinguished students nominees for the class of 2020 are distinguished student is Mr. Ryan Chua. Congratulations, Ryan. Ryan is the son of Winston and Ronaby Chua. While at Tilghman, Ryan has been recognized as a National Merit Finalist, AP Scholar with Distinction, Kentucky Governor Scholar, Paducah Sun Teen of the Week, Rotary Club Student of the Month, Center Fellow, served as Tilghman Student Ambassador, and is an Eagle Scout and exceptional violinist. Ryan plans to attend the University of Michigan, where he plans to major in computer science and specialize in cybersecurity and artificial intelligence. Congratulations, Ryan, on this prestigious honor. Thank you. Seniors, on behalf of the Paducah Board of Education and the Commonwealth of Kentucky, I ask that you move your tassel from your right to your left side of your cap as I proudly pronounce you graduates of Paducah Tilghman High School. Congratulations.
Congratulations!